Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. It's Princess Reni here, and if you are new, please don't forget to go down and subscribe by either clicking on my picture or scrolling down, you'll see the subscribe button. If you are coming back for the second, third, fourth, 20th time, thank you for coming back. I hope you guys really enjoyed this video, as I am really excited to put it out. With that being said, we're gonna just get right into it. So you guys know it's real whenever I'm sitting down, I'm ready to talk to you. Have my background set up. I'm actually sitting in my office and I'm still working on like tweaking a few things, but this is like what I have as of right now. But this is something that has been laying on my heart for the longest while, and I just couldn't get myself to do the video because I wanted to be genuine. I wanted to come to you guys and be as real as possible whenever I'm putting out any kind of information, right? Any video that I come out, I come to you guys as real as ever. My hair is looking crazy and all that stuff. However, today's video is not necessarily going to be about my hair. Today, I'm going to get back into Christian Chronicles. Yeah! If you have seen my video, I'm actually going to link it up here. It is called Spilling the Tea on Myself, where I share everything about my Christian journey from being a preteen all the way up to 2018 when I posted the video. So everything that I've experienced, whether it was living a double life and, you know, basically being a hypocrite, walking around, only being a Christian in church, but outside of church, I was doing something completely different. So what God has laid on my heart was I needed to address certain things that the world perceives Christians as. Like, we're perceived as, yes, hypocrites, I said that. We're perceived as, you know, not being real. Like, we live our lives one way whenever we're in church and another way when we're outside of church. There's this meme where it's like, I love Jesus, but my hands still work type thing. And it's real, like it's real. And I want to address some of those things that pertain to me. This is my personal like experience and things that I'm dealing with or have dealt with. I am gonna open up the floor for you guys to share some things that you're dealing with, and maybe I can go into those topics depending on if they apply to me. I wrote down a few things that I want to cover. And when I started writing down these lists, or even as I was thinking, it was just like a lot of things were coming to me. And God was like, yes, you got to talk about this, and you got to talk about that, and that, and that. And I'm like, geez, like, I feel like at the end of the day, God wants me to share my life and my journey. That's why I created a YouTube video, so that other people out there that may be going through the same thing as I am can find, I don't want to say find the answers, but get revelations from my experience. Still a part of Christian Chronicles, but it's called I'm Christian But / Christian Chronicles, okay? You follow me? Okay. So I wrote down a few things and a few others came to my mind, so I'm not gonna say all of them right now, but each of these are gonna have their own separate videos where I will talk more in depth about how it applies to me, and of course, how I can apply God's word so that I can receive healing and so I can be transformed through his word, so that I'm not this hypocritical Christian, as some people may call it. I do want to address certain things that the world may perceive and say, well, Christians are so religious. Christianity is a religion, but it's also a lifestyle. It's mainly a lifestyle. It's not only when you're in church, but also outside of church, when you're at work, when you're in school, wherever you go, you must reflect Christ. So some of the things that I've dealt with before and some of the things that I'm still dealing with right now, I want to address. So one, I'm Christian, but I don't like people sometimes. I'm Christian, but sometimes I curse. I'm Christian, but I can't let go of the past. I'm Christian, but I like to show some skin. I'm Christian, but I can't forgive. I'm Christian, and I have a sinful nature. Wanted to impart this into you guys to let you know what is to come next. With that being said, I would love for you guys to comment down below any other ideas or any other things that you've heard from other people where it's like, oh, she's Christian, but look at the way she's living her life, and he's Christian, he's sagging his pants, or whatever the case may be. What are some things that you might have heard or said about someone else that you guys might want me to cover in Christian Chronicles? Again, I have a longer list than that, and they're just coming to me as I go. But those are some of the topics that I'll be covering. And again, it's very, very important for us to get into God's Word. So one of the scriptures that I want to leave with you guys, and we'll definitely have a lot more scriptures throughout this series, but this one I want to leave with you guys comes from 2 Peter chapter 1, verse 3. It says, "By His divine power, God has given us everything we need for living a godly life. We have received all of this by coming to know Him, the one who called us to Himself, by means of His marvelous glory and excellence." So what this scripture is telling me is that God's word, it sets us up to live a godly life. All we need to do, or all the answers we're looking for how we should live our lives, what we should do, how we should say, how we should carry ourselves, that's all within God's word. And God is saying that He's provided us this answer, or provided us what we need to live a godly life once we got to know Him. Once we decided to come to Him, into His throne of grace, and accept Him as our Lord and Savior. So sometimes you might see some Christians that are not living their lives the right way. Instead of condemning them or making them feel like, you know, you're not a Christian because now you're living like this. There's this famous, famous song that a lot of people know. A saint is just a sinner who fell down and got up. So we sin every day. We sin in word, thought, and deed. So it's very important for us to remember that if we want to turn our lives around, we want to change what it is that we're doing, we need to get back into God's word. And this is ministering onto me as well. I need to get back into God's word. And I'm really excited that I'm doing this and holding myself accountable. I do have my journal here that I've been writing in. And this year has been a challenge, and I'm gonna be real with you guys. It has been a challenge, and I feel like God is calling me to document it, not just in my journal, but also to document it here on YouTube, so that you guys know, like, sometimes times are gonna be tough, it's gonna be challenging, but you still need to trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not onto your own understanding, which comes from Proverbs chapter 3, verse 5. And you guys remember this book. I've had it for so long. I try to limit what I'm writing in it just because I just love the cover and I want to keep it for as long as possible. So what I write in these are revelations and certain scriptures, certain words that God reveals to me, and things that I don't want to forget. So I do remember in the beginning of this year, I was praying and fasting. And I remember one thing that God shared with me for 2020. And mind you, this was January 20th, towards the end of the fast, because it was a 21-day fast, that God shared this with me. And I haven't, or at least I don't remember, rereading this part until this week. What week are we in? This is July. So until July. This is like crazy. God was preparing me for all of this. It's just everything that God has shared with me in January. I'm seeing myself go through it right now, and I'm like, why didn't I open this sooner? Like, why didn't I go to this specific page sooner? I feel like a lot of the ways that I handle different situations would have been different if I had went back into my journal. So let's be a message to you guys as well. Let's continue journaling, write down the things that God is revealing to you, and whether you choose to share it with someone or not, definitely make sure that you're going back and you're rereading it. I had a journal from 2016 when I told you guys, like, I was in a depressed state, I was going through a lot, and I was just busy working to get my mind off of it. There were nights that I wrote in the journal, and a lot of the things that I wrote, I couldn't believe, like, that was my mindset. You know, it was dark, you know, so to see how far I've come now, it's like amazing. And I mean, of course, there's still a lot of room for growth, but I just thank God for His revelation knowledge. And I thank Him for continuing to speak to me. I don't hear His voice every day, but the times that I do hear His voice, I'm grateful for it because it's so timely. So we are gonna get into this new series, which is I'm Christian, But, which is also part of Christian Chronicles. We'll be talking about all of those things that apply to Christians, but but then apply to people of the world that a lot of Christians still have within them, you know? And God commands us, which is another scripture that I want us to go over. He commands us in his word to not be conformed by the things of this world. And I'm going to read it exactly how it's written in the word. So it comes from Romans chapter 12, verse 2. It says, "Do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewal of your mind, that by testing you may discern what is the will of God, what is good and acceptable and perfect." So we need to know what God's will is. We don't want to be looking like the world if we say we're Christian. You can still reach the people out there without looking like them. A lot of people feel like, oh, if I'm going to be a Christian evangelist, I need to go out into the world and I need to be like them. I need to sing the songs they're singing and dress like them and all that. No, there is a way to do it. And the Holy Spirit reveals it to each and every one of us, the approach that he wants us to take. But he doesn't want us to be like the world. He wants us to be set apart. So I'm really, really, really excited for this series. If you cannot tell, I am rambling. So I'm going to go ahead and stop the video now. You guys are just as excited as I am to see what the Holy Spirit reveals to us in this season. And yeah, thanks again for watching, guys. I hope you guys enjoy the rest of your day or evening, whatever time it is that you're watching this video. Be blessed, spread love, and stay beautiful inside and out. Bye, guys. Thank you.